Should I give a shout out to Kendra R?
I mean, you don't have to.
For, do you want me to? Yeah. This is amazing.
If this restaurant were a movie, it would get high marks for costume design, failing grades for the script and acting.
I can't really review the food because they refuse to serve me.
Forget about getting a reservation. The system is rigged. The business arrogance is apparent.
Host looks down at his iPad, says with an optimistic tone, it's looking like five and a half hours.
You can take non-Jewish friends here and not be embarrassed.
The place is a freaking bakery. Would it kill them to include a slice of bread?
The decor is tacky. I did like the hotel fold on the toilet paper. 1 star, good for you.
I'll have an Italian, either with gluten-free bread or without bread entirely. We don't do that, Mr. Manager told me. We have a policy of only making sandwiches, apparently forgetting about the $69 chicken on his menu.
The problem is that the food just isn't all that good.
Just be careful whom you invite to brunch in case they decide to order an $180 omelet.
With caviar.
With caviar.
I flew in to Seattle from New York and convinced my buddy to drive us for what essentially amounted to boy chicken over rice. F-ing white people.
Host looks at us with a smile on his face as though we're going to be interested in putting our names on the list to have dinner at 1:30 in the morning.
I logged into their system at 1 a.m. Eastern, midnight Nashville, and got a message that all reservations were taken. How could this be? I have been trying for 2 years. I am done with this restaurant.
The sweet potato soup was warming and good, but not orgasmic.
You're not getting another Michelin star because of that.
Seriously, dude. Take your pretentious attitude and shove it.
Do I hear a dog barking upstairs? The dog was upstairs.
If you're looking for design tips and want to scout out a pretty space, go here. If not, skip it.